हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, यू आर वेलकम इन द लेक्चर नंबर 10 ऑफ ए चैप्टर ऑफ सॉलिड स्टेट. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द पॉइंट ऑफ क्रिस्टल डिफेक्ट्स एंड वी हैव कंप्लीटेड स्टाइशोमेट्रिक डिफेक्ट्स. वन टाइप ऑफ डिफेक्ट्स ऑलरेडी वी हैव कंप्लीटेड, स्टाइशोमेट्रिक डिफेक्ट्स. व्हाट इज मीन बाय डिफेक्ट? What is meant by imperfections that we have studied? We know that crystalline substance is the substance where there is a regular arrangement of atoms or ions or molecules is present for a longer distance. But is there a crystal perfectly crystalline in nature? That is studied with the help of defects. It is observed that there are certain disorders, irregularities present in the structure of crystal. Those irregularities in the structure of crystal, disorders in the structure of crystal, are known as crystal defects or imperfections, not perfections. What are the reasons? That also we have studied. Defects in the crystal occur because of faster rate of crystallization. If the rate of crystallization is very high, crystallization take place in a fast manner, at that time crystal defects occur. So the better way to minimize the crystal defects is to decrease the rate of crystallization. Crystallization must be done slowly so that defects are minimized. Further, defects are minimized whenever the temperature of crystallization is absolute zero. And there we have seen that in certain cases, intentionally, impurities or intentionally defects are produced. By producing the defects, manipulation in the better properties is done in the crystals. Better properties are increased in the crystals by increasing the defects in certain cases. They are intensively done. And then we have studied that there are three type of defects. They are point defect, line defect, and sheet defect. Point, line, or sheet, that is plane defects. And first type of point defects are there only in our syllabus. Again, those point defects are of three types. What is meant by point defect? Point defect arises due to irregularity, disorder in the sequence of points occupied by the bases, occupied by the particles. When your lattice points are disorderly occupied by the particles, defects are produced known as point defects. There are three types of point defects. Which are those three types? Stoichiometric defect. Second, impurity defect, which we are studying today. And the third is non-stoichiometric defects. Here, non-stoichiometric defects. First one, stoichiometric defects we have completed. What is meant by stoichiometry? Stoichiometry is nothing but a ratio of atoms in molecule. For example, in MgCl2, what is the ratio of atoms? 1:2, 1 magnesium and 2 chlorine. So ratio of atom is fixed. That is known as stoichiometry. Or ratio of ions, cation to anion. NaCl, 1:1, 1 Na plus 1 Cl minus. Ratio of cation to anion is 1:1. That ratio is not changing. Even though defects are produced, even though irregularities are produced, स्टाइशियोमेट्रिक बैलेंस इज नॉट डिस्टर्बड, स्टाइशियोमेट्री इज नॉट डिस्टर्बड, स्टाइशियोमेट्री इज नॉट चेंज्ड, दे आर नोन एज स्टाइशियोमेट्रिक डिफेक्ट्स. एंड इन स्टाइशियोमेट्रिक डिफेक्ट्स वी हैव सीन वैकेंसी डिफेक्ट वेयर पार्टिकल्स आर मिसिंग, एटम्स आर मिसिंग. देन वी हैव स्टडीड सेल्फ इंटरस्टिशियल डिफेक्ट्स, पार्टिकल्स आर इनकॉर्पोरेटेड इन द इंटरस्टिशियल पोजिशंस. वी हैव स्टडीड शॉटकी डिफेक्ट, फ्रेंकल डिफेक्ट, शॉटकी डिफेक्ट टेकिंग प्लेस इन द आयोनिक सॉलिड्स, फ्रेंकल डिफेक्ट्स ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन द आयोनिक सॉलिड्स. रीजन फॉर शॉटकी एंड फ्रेंकल डिफेक्ट वी हैव स्टडीड. इन शॉटकी डिफेक्ट कोऑर्डिनेशन नंबर इज वेरी हाई, साइज ऑफ कटायन एंड एनायन इज ऑलमोस्ट सेम, वेरी स्मॉल डिफरेंस, कोऑर्डिनेशन नंबर इज वेरी हाई एंड इक्वल नंबर ऑफ कटायन एंड एनायन आर मिसिंग, सो रेशियो रिमेन्स सेम, दे आर नथिंग बट दी शॉटकी डिफेक्ट्स. इन फ्रेंकल डिफेक्ट वी हैव स्टडीड कोऑर्डिनेशन नंबर इज लो बट द रेशियो ऑफ साइज ऑफ एनायन एंड कटायन इज वेरी डिफरेंट. साइज ऑफ एनायन इज वेरी मच बिगर एज कंपेयर्ड विद द साइज ऑफ कटायन. देयरफॉर कटायंस मूव फ्रॉम ओरिजिनल साइट एंड दे ऑक्युपाई द इंटरस्टिशियल पोजिशन. दे आर फ्रेंकल डिफेक्ट्स. बाय ऑल दोज डिफेक्ट्स स्टाइशियोमेट्री इज नॉट डिस्टर्ब्ड. दैट इज द अकाउंट ऑफ लास्ट लेक्चर. नाउ द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, सेकंड टाइप ऑफ डिफेक्ट्स आर इम्प्यूरिटी डिफेक्ट्स. हेयर फर्स्ट वन इज सब्स्टिट्यूशनल इम्प्यूरिटी डिफेक्ट. सब्स्टिट्यूशनल, सी व्हाट इज मीन बाय इम्प्यूरिटी डिफेक्ट. इन द मेन सब्सटेंस, मेन पार्टिकल, मेन क्रिस्टलाइन सब्सटेंस, सम ऑफ द इम्प्यूरिटीज आर इनकॉर्पोरेटेड. सम ऑफ द लैटिस पॉइंट्स आर ऑक्युपाइड बाय इम्प्यूरिटी पार्टिकल्स. द मेन पार्टिकल ऑफ दैट सब्सटेंस इज नोन एज अ होस्ट. मेन पार्टिकल ऑफ ए सब्सटेंस इज नोन एज ए होस्ट. एंड द पार्टिकल विच इज एडेड एज एन इम्प्यूरिटी इज द इम्प्यूरिटी पार्टिकल. सम ऑफ द इम्प्यूरिटी पार्टिकल्स ऑक्युपाइज द होस्ट पोजिशंस ऑल्सो. दिस इज फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशनल इम्प्यूरिटी डिफेक्ट. हेयर हेयर व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, कॉपर, सी दिस इज अ स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ब्रास. इट इज अ स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ब्रास. इन द ब्रास कॉपर इज नथिंग बट द मेन मेटल, होस्ट मेटल. ब्रास, ब्रास इज अलॉय, सोल्यूशन ऑफ मेटल्स. वन मेटल प्रेजेंट इन लेस प्रपोर्शन, अदर मेटल प्रेजेंट इन द लार्ज एक्सेस प्रपोर्शन. सो सोल्यूशन ऑफ मेटल्स, दैट इज मेटल अलॉय. टू मेटल्स आर टुगेदर. मेन मेटल, होस्ट मेटल इज नथिंग बट कॉपर. द साइज ऑफ कॉपर and the size of zinc is almost same. So what happen? Some of the copper particles are replaced by zinc particles. So zinc is nothing but the impurity metal and copper is host metal. Properties are enhanced. Properties of copper are increased, better properties are increased, and this type of effect, defect is produced, known as substitutional impurity defect. The second type, one more type of substitutional impurity defect take place by this manner. So how it is taking place over here? If the substance like NaCl is considered, ionic crystal, NaCl, ionic. To this NaCl, if the impurities of SrCl2 are added, see what happen. Na plus and Cl minus, they will occupy the particular lattice points in a sequence. But what happens is that if SrCl2 is added, Sr has oxidation number higher than sodium. What is the oxidation number of Sr? Plus 2. It is losing 2 electrons. What is the oxidation number of Na? Plus 1. So what happens is that Sr plus 2 is known as allovalent impurity. Allovalent impurity. What is mean by allovalent impurity? It is the impurity ion which has higher oxidation number as compared with the host ion. Host ion has oxidation number plus 1 and impurity ion has oxidation number plus 2. Therefore, this is known as allovalent impurity ion. And whenever this type of impurity ion is added, what happens? See here, it has a oxidation state plus 2, it will replace 2 Na plus ions. See, here is one Na plus ion missing. Here also one Na plus ion missing. And one Sr plus 2 is added. 2 Na plus means 2 positive charges are missing. And those 2 positive charges are balanced by Sr plus 2. So is there disturbance of stoichiometry? Yes or no? No. Stoichiometry is not disturbed. Stoichiometry, ratio of charges, cation to anion is same. Ratio of charges is same. 2 Na plus are replaced by 1 Sr plus 2. This is the second type of defect produced, substitutional impurity defect. One more substitutional defect, impurity defect, is nothing but interstitial impurity defect. Interstitial. If we see, this is a structure of SS. What is meant by SS? Do you know SS, short form? Long form of SS, stainless steel. Stainless steel we are using in day-to-day life. Stainless steel is alloy of iron and carbon. Here, the regular particle is iron. Lattice points are occupied by the iron atoms. These are the lattice points occupied by iron. And in between we know, what is this space? It is known as interspecial space, interstitial space. Carbon atom, which has very small size, they will occupy the interstitial positions and hardness of iron increases. That is known as stainless steel. So, at the start of defects, I have told you, intentionally sometimes defects are produced. Here it is intention to produce brass. Convert copper into brass by addition of zinc impurities is intention. Here also it is intention to convert iron to the stainless steel. Still, it is intention to increase the better properties, best properties, to enhance the best properties. They are second type of effects, defects, impurity defect. One more third type of defect is there, non-stoichiometric defects. Non-stoichiometric means stoichiometry is not balanced. After the defect, stoichiometry is disturbed. Here first one is nothing but metal deficiency defect. See, no doubt in some of the cases stoichiometry is balanced. In some of the cases it may not be balanced. They are non-stoichiometric defects. First one is metal deficiency defect. See, what is done in the metal deficiency defect? The regular substance is NiO, nickel oxide, NiO, regular substance, where Ni has oxidation state of plus 2. NiO is a regular substance. Ni plus plus and oxygen minus minus. So plus two charges, plus two, they are nothing but the Ni plus two ions. And minus two means oxide ions. This type of effects, metal deficiency defect, is produced where metal will have, metal is existing in more than one different oxidation states. Nickel has oxidation state Ni++. It also has oxidation state Ni++. So whenever the impurities of Ni plus 3 are added to Ni plus 2, this type of defect occur, metal deficiency defect occurs. What happened in this structure? You will easily come to know from the structure also. Here one Ni plus 2 is missing. Plus 2 minus 2 plus 2 minus 2. So here one plus 2 is missing. Two positive charges are less. But how they are balanced? Here one Ni plus 3 and one Ni plus 3. How many Ni plus 3 are there? 2. Minus 2 plus 2. 1 plus charge is excess. Minus 2 plus 2. 1 plus 2 1 plus 1 charge is excess. So plus 1 and plus 1, plus 2 charges are excess. They will balance these charges. But deficiency occur, metal deficiency. Ni plus 2 is less. Charges are balanced. Charges are balanced. But one deficiency hole is produced. And this is known as metal deficiency defect. Second one is metal excess defect. Metal excess. Here in metal excess defect, what happened? Zn plus 2 and minus 2, plus 2 minus 2, plus 2 minus 2, they are there in sequence. Whenever some of the zinc neutral particles are added over here, it is observed that neutral particles occupy the which positions? Interstitial positions. Due to their smaller size, neutral atom, zinc neutral atom occupies interstitial positions besides the ions, plus 2 and minus 2 ions. So here excess atoms are there. So metal excess defect. Here is also ion excess defect. See how this defect is produced. Zn plus 2 minus 2 plus 2 minus 2. Then minus 2 plus 2 minus 2 plus 2 is there. But here Zn plus 2 ion is in excess. Whenever zinc oxide is heated, it is observed that zinc oxide on heating get converted to Zn plus 2. Oxygen and electrons. See the reaction. Reaction is like this. Zinc oxide on heating converted to Zn plus 2 plus half O2 plus 2 electrons. So whenever zinc oxide is heated, Zn plus 2 and minus 2 are there. But besides that, what happened? Excess of Zn plus 2 ions are obtained. Those excess of Zn plus 2 ions occupy the interstitial positions. And electrons, two electrons are there. So one and two. These electrons are also there in the interstitial position, balancing charges. So this type of defect is nothing but the metal excess defect, excess ion defect. And one more, by anion vacancy. Anion vacancy. See here, this is the vacancy. Actually, this part is nothing but a vacancy. Whenever sodium chloride is heated with sodium vapors, sodium chloride, whenever treated and heated with the sodium vapor, what happens is that sodium, neutral sodium, sorry, Na plus ion in excess deposited at the surface. Therefore, Cl minus ion present in the internal layers get diffused at the surface and produces the hole. And that hole is occupied by the electrons. See, there are electrons. How the electrons are produced? Na and Cl minus. Whenever Na neutral react with Cl minus, get converted to Na plus plus Cl plus one electron. This is the reaction. NaCl directly Na Cl minus means if it is Na plus with Cl minus it gives NaCl and one electron is obtained. So what is the reaction? The reaction is such that sodium chloride is treated with sodium vapors. Excess of sodium in the form of ion is deposited at the surface and electrons present in the internal layers get diffused at the surface. Cl minus ions present in the internal layers get diffused at the surface, leaving behind electron hole. Electrons which are released at the surface occupy the hole. This is known as EF center, and it gives the imparts color. It imparts color to the NaCl. So with that, we have completed all the defects.